My personal style of documentaries, I call it observational films, and actually it has nothing to do with the tradition of Japanese documentary cinema. Actually, I practice it as a reaction to the Japanese TV documentaries, because I was a TV documentary filmmaker before I became a filmmaker. And I had a lot of frustration of, you know, how they make films, I mean, programs, TV shows, because on TV shows you have to always research first and then make a synopsis and script, and then you have to follow the original plan. So it's very hard to make discoveries.
北京の急激な成長とともに伸び続けてきた道路は、
You always need to put narration and music, and there's a set format, and it's not very free.
的な問題が潜んでいると、
There are many people who are fed up with the TV style documentaries. My, in a sense, anti-TV format style and method kind of appeal to the public. I think the reason why Japanese documentary is reviving is mainly because of the digital revolution, I think, you know. It used to be very hard to make documentaries even if you wanted, because you have to use 16mm camera, separate sound, and it costs a lot of money. Compared to other nations, I think, you know, documentary filmmakers in Japan have this, you know, tradition of being economically poor. And, but within the limitation, each, you know, filmmaker had some sort of had to struggle and find their own way of making documentaries. And also, so Ogawa Shinsuke was also deep in debt because of continuing making films, and he couldn't pay his staffs, and you know, everybody was suffering because of that. But still, he kept going. Even if you shoot it, there was not so much way to show it. During the time of Tsuchimoto and Ogawa, political movement in Japan was really active. So these organization or student organization can organize screenings and here and there, and they could be also a sponsor to the films. In this day and age, you know, political climate is, you know, I mean, we don't have that kind of movement anymore. I'm calling my films observational films because I wanted to kind of challenge the public or the audience. Because I think, you know, in this day and age, what's really most lacking is the observation. We are in a society where it's so fast-paced, and we don't have time to think and time to look and time to listen and really think about that, or see it with your own eyes and think with your own brain. And that's what's really lacking. That's creating a lot of problems. When you're making documentaries, you know, no matter what kind of style you are taking, you know, you have to observe and make a documentary according to your observation. You can't just jump to a conclusion, or you have the set agenda and take whatever that fits to your own agenda, and then it's not documentary. Yeah. So yeah, I hope it means something to somebody.